With Gary Reasons, glad to have you aboard. Texas, a final prep before Big 12 play. They enter at 3-0 after a close call last week against Central Florida. Gary, they like to have a dominating performance. If they do get that, you got to figure their star tailback, Jamaal Charles, will be a part of it.
Well, Jamaal Charles has done great so far this season, Bill. He leads the Big 12 in rushing, over 133 yards per ball game. He's a big play weapon in that offense. When they put the ball in his hands, he can take it the distance. They're going to need him to be a workhorse like he's been the first 3 weeks.
Now for the Rice Owls, they're 0-3. They're banged up a bit. Third straight Big 12 foe for the Rice Ball Club. If they're going to pull off the upset, you know they're All-American. Jared Dillard will be involved.
Well, Jared Dillard, he's a big play receiver for these guys. He's their all-time leading touchdown receiver, 27 of those for his career. They need to get the ball in his hands. He needs to make some big plays if the Owls are going to have a chance here in Austin.
Well, the Owls think they do have a chance. They saw how Central Florida scared Texas last week. They're fired up here today. Old Southwest Conference rival.
Kyocera's College Football Saturday here in Austin, Texas. It is Rice and Texas going at it. Longhorns 3-0, a 35-32 win over Central Florida. And the Rice Owls coming off a loss to Texas Tech 59-24. They are 0-3. First-year head coach David Bailiff, who very familiar to people in this part of the state of Texas, was at Texas State down the road in San Marcos for 3 years. Took them within a game of a national championship fight in 1AA and taken over a Rice team that last year went to a bowl with a mark of 7-6. And of course, Mack Brown in his 10th year here at the University of Texas. And anytime you rack up the numbers he's racking up, you are great at home, as you can see by that note there at 49-5. Bill Land, Gary Reasons, Emily Jones with you. Glad to have you aboard as we're about ready to kick this one off. As Rice won the coin flip, deferred to the second half. Texas electing to receive, and the Longhorns, who want to get it on track tonight. They were gracious and glad to win against Central Florida, but they certainly know they're going to have to play better than that if they're going to win in the Big 12. And here's interesting, with the kickoff being moved back to the 30, Gary, there hadn't been a whole lot of difference as far as average starting field position. Just 5 yards, like you'd expect.
Yeah, when you look at it, the numbers are really just not giving you offenses a whole lot of advantage, but the coaches still feel like it does give them advantage. It's just a little momentum thing. When you start a little bit further up that field, it gives you a little more confidence going out there.
Luke Juice is kicking it off. Cosby will touch it back, and he'll come out to the 20-yard line. So that extra 5 yards, not a problem for the Rice kicker, Luke Juice. And now let's take a look at our Kyocera starting lineup for the Texas Longhorns as quarterback Colt McCoy leads this team out. McCoy last week throwing for 259 yards and a touchdown in that Central Florida win. Charles has been over 100 in every game from the backfield position, and their offensive line is beginning to gel for this group. It's a big bunch up front as Texas will have it first and 10 from its own 20-yard line. A fake to Charles and McCoy to put it up, and it is incomplete. Intended for Quan Cosby. Cosby, 21 receptions coming in, 147 yards. Kyocera provides our starting lineup for the Rice Owls. The Owls, who have been allowing 39 points a game on the defensive front, but they've got a Butkus Award candidate in that linebacker, Brian Rames, who last year a first-team all-conference pick in Conference USA, and comes in their leading tackler with 26.
We've got a 4-2-5 defense against the Longhorns here. They have a lot of people near the line of scrimmage to try to slow down the run game of the Longhorns.
And the ball's handed off, and it's intercepted as he fumbled it, and it's picked up in midair by Joseph Leary, and the Rice Owls on the turnover have the football at the 19-yard line.
What a big play by a true freshman, Joseph Leary, starting at the cat linebacker spot for the Rice Owls. Gets his ball from Jamaal Charles, and one of the things we talked to Jamaal Charles about was fumbling that football. He had a couple go on the ground last week against Central Florida. It happens on him on the first carry today from scrimmage. That's a huge play for Rice, and when you come in here to a hostile environment, you need to make key plays on the road, and David Bayless' group got the first one in their favor.
Nate Jones made the tackle as the turnover on the fumble, and here are the Rice Owls now, and this crowd kind of casually coming into the stadium saying, wait a minute here. You've been paying attention to what's been going on in college football today, and in September, it has been wild, and Rice trying to get some early momentum. On a first and 10, as Chase Clement, the quarterback, goes back to pass. looking in the end zone and just off the fingertips of Jared Diller. Palmer was covering on the play. Kiosero, give us our starting lineup. As you saw, two of the standouts performing there, Clement the quarterback and Dillard the wide receiver. They've also got a couple of all-conference linemen in Barber and Eos up front.
And Rice has this wide open spread style offense. They'll be in the shotgun most of the night and look for a lot of varying formations from these guys and get the ball down here in the red zone early in the ball game. They've got to put points on the board.
Second and 10. Delayed on the handoff and nothing going on that particular run. Justin Hill. Let's take a look at the Texas defensive group, again brought to you by Kyocera, Houston, Loki, Ocam, Lewis, Killebrew, the veteran linebacking core there, Palmer, Griffin, Jackson, and Beasley, the secondary for the University of Texas. Texas allowing 324 yards total offense to their opponents. Third down and 14, the ball on the 23 now. In trouble and gets rid of the football. And is it alive? No. We had a delayed whistle though because Texas was there. Wait a minute. Ocam putting the pressure on Clement that time.
Well, I tell you, the quarterback doesn't want to have anything to do with Frank Ocam when he breaks through in the middle of that line there. Watch number 97 on the twist come right through there. It's a blow of protection by the Owls and Clement has to get rid of the football. Smartly throws it down on the ground though and called a penalty on the intentional grounding and lost it down there because he did not get the ball at a receiver across the line of scrimmage because he was about to be tackled by Frank Ocam. So the Owls are now backed up and this will be a long field goal attempt here early in the ball game. They were down inside the 20-yard line, but now around the 33-yard line, Bill.
All right, they come on for the 50-yard field goal attempt. Clark Fangmeyer. And no good. Fangmeyer, who had come in 2 of 3, hitting on a 44-yarder, misses a 50-yarder, and Texas up in HD by Hitachi. Bill Landgary Reasons, Emily Jones with you on FSN. College football from Austin, where Texas on its opening possession fumbled. Rice, a golden opportunity, and comes up with nothing, missing on the 50-yard field goal attempt. And as a result, the Longhorns get the ball right back at the 33-yard line with 13:48 to go in the first quarter.
Nice job by the Longhorn defense turning the Owls back.
Holt McCoy, the quarterback. Great hitch, and it is complete and out across the 40 to the 41-yard line.
You know, Bill, we talked about fumbles in this ballgame. We talked to Mac Brown about what he talked about, ball security and how important it is. They lost it first fumble. We talked to Mac. Let's hear what he had to say.
We constantly talk about ball security, and we're excited that Jamal is only the second back in our 10 years to have 3 100-yard games to start the season. Not even Ricky Williams did that. Cedric Benson was the other young man. But since he's running so aggressively up inside, he was not carrying the ball sloppily, but he's just going to have to be tighter, keep it down, rub it against his side, and make sure that when he gets in traffic like he was the other day, he puts two hands on it.
And it's interesting that Charles, who had two fumbles the other day, talking about Central Florida, and you worked with him yesterday on what he was talking about.
Yeah, I talked to him. I said Earl Campbell actually worked with him. Grabbed his shoe. Earl took his shoe off and said, "Here, show you. I'm going to show you how to do this." And so Jamal was talking to me and showing me how he did it. And he's working on getting that ball protected and keeping it lower and the elbow close to his body.
Had that last carry here that gave him a first down. This one is flipped outside and is complete to Finley.
And
Jeremichael Finley, a sophomore, 6'5", 240. His second reception tonight, he had the one earlier on this drive. He's now got 14 on the season.
Well, that's what the weapons are here for Colt McCoy. He's got a good command of the offense now. His second year running the show for him. He knows where his players are, and he knows how to operate back there now with this offense.
And McCoy going nowhere this time as he's brought down by George Chukwu. He is a senior out of Houston, 6'2", 305. And gets his second tackle for loss on the season.
Well, you can string things out from the inside out. He's actually the inside two technique to tackle, breaks through the guard. That should never happen on that play on the down the line option. That's a break by the Longhorns up front. Chukwu just showing his power and strength and good speed to the outside to get McCoy.
And he was an honorable mention all-conference pick at CUSA last year. Third and eight. And big hit. See where they mark it. Did he make the first down as it's complete to Cosby? Shepherd making the tackle in the secondary for the Owls.
Yeah, Quan Cosby's turned out to be the number two receiver here on this team this season. Only one reception's coming into the ball game, and McCoy throws it out there to him. This is great concentration for him to catch it, but a good hit by Shepherd. Did not dislodge the football, but good contact there and good job of holding on the ball by Cosby.
And it'll be fourth down and two. And Texas coming on with Trevor Gerland, the punter, sophomore from Katy, Texas, the Houston area, Cinco Ranch High School. And Rice with nobody back and not going for anything here. And now Texas will take a timeout. We'll take a break. Texas going for it now after the timeout. Fourth and two from the 42 of the Rice Owls. Second possession for Texas. They fumble on their opening snap, or their opening possession. Rice could not take advantage of it and score. And now they sit fourth and two at the Owls 42.
I think this is the right call by Matt Brown here. Go for it on fourth down. You're at home. You need to make a statement here and get this first down.
And Charles has it. Across the 40 to the 39-yard line. Jamal Charles, the junior, on a Port Arthur Memorial. And George Duku makes the tackle for the Rice Owls. That'll move the chains for Texas.
Yeah, if you have any chance of being a dominant football team, you got to be able to go against a team that's perhaps a lesser opponent here at home. Fourth and two, you need to get that first down and keep your drive alive. It would have been a tough decision, I think, for Mac to go ahead and punt the ball away. That would give up two offensive possessions for the Owls with nothing coming from it. One with a fumble with Jamal Charles in the first series, and now with that carry, he does get the first down, so Texas now has a chance to put something up on the board.
First attempt from the 39, right across the middle. It is complete down near the 31-yard line. Nate Jones, the receiver, senior out of Texarkana, Texas, and Brian Raines, all-star linebacker for Rice, with a stop for the Owls.
Well, this is just showing you Colt McCoy savvy here. He surveys the defense. He knows he's got a clear out route, and someone coming underneath does a good job to get it to him. And good news here for Colt McCoy. He's got number four out there as well. Lima Sweet had an ankle injury a week ago, but he's definitely playing tonight.
Little draw play. Charles dances and then finds a spot and bursts through and has the first down again for the Longhorns.
Yeah, and Lima Sweet, talking about him, he's the guy that gives them that down-the-field vertical capability. He's a big receiver and someone that Colt McCoy needs to get more in tune with. Doesn't have a lot of grabs on the year so far, Bill. He's only got 10 receptions coming into this ball game. But Lima Sweet is that unique caliber of athlete and that receiver that needs to be a big playmaker for this football team.
And he's a little bit banged up, but they say he's been that way most of the time here. And he has had 10 receptions for 128 yards, one touchdown through the first three games. First and 10 at the 27. Ball's loose. McCoy picks it up. Finds a man, and it is complete. Cosby, he's got a first down as he takes it near the 15-yard line, and Brandon King there for the Owls.
Well, almost a mishap, but Colt McCoy does a smart thing, gets the ball under control. Great blocking up front, though, by his offensive lineman. They do a good job. Watch the line here. They do a good job holding everybody out. He has enough time to pick it, and just too much cushion there by the secondary of Rice. Too much cushion there, and Cosby able to find some room there in the secondary, and Brandon King just not close enough for him to make a play.
Clock ticking, 9:46 in the first, and first and 10 on the 16. Charles looking for some place to cut it up, and Rice is there after a couple of yards. And near the 8-yard line, Brian Raines, rather the 13, Raines makes a stop there.
You know, Jamal Charles has turned in kind of a workhorse, Bill. You know, in the first three ball games, he's had 71 carries. Now he's got two or three here tonight. They're going to feed him the football. You know, have three 100-yard rushing games. He's one of only two backs in University of Texas history to do that, the other one being Cedric Benson, and he'd like to get another one, get four perhaps to start this season.
Second and eight. And again, here is Swede on the toss and fighting for an extra yard or two before he's pushed out of bounds by a host of Owls. And it'll be third and short now for Texas.
And when you have the threat of the run game with Jamal Charles inside and even around the edge, and Colt McCoy being able to run it around the edge as well, you really open up the things in a passing game for your outside receivers. And You take a Lima Sweet, a big receiver, a guy who's going to get open just from the pure nature of his ability and his getting separation with his size. Those are good tools for Colt McCoy to work with.
See what Texas does here on a third and three. Charles stretching it out, hit hard, and then powers his way for a first and goal situation for the Longhorns.
Jamal Charles showing that he's got enough elusiveness and ability to make a decision.
79 offense, 10-yard penalty, replay, third down.
Yeah, big Tony Hill's the left tackle, who's actually played very well for Mac Brown this season. Getting called for the hold. You're going to get Tony right up here and watch him push that defensive end out. And there's, well, I don't know, there's the hold right there at the end of the play. Good call there by the officials. When you get your hands extended, he grabbed Justin at the strong safety on the play coming up trying to make the tackle. So the Longhorns get backed up, and it's third down now. And one of the things they've been poor on, Bill, this season is scoring consistently in the red area. Here they are now at third and long once they got in the red area.
Yeah, and they've number 11 in red zone offense in the Big 12, and this is a team that expects to do much better than that. Third and 12 here. McCoy, plenty of time. Complete! Touchdown, Texas! That is Cosby! Von Cosby gets his first touchdown of the season through the air. He's been a big playmaker throughout this drive, and he gets the six.
It seems like he's got a great chemistry right now working with Colt McCoy and working up the seam there to the middle of the field. And Cosby's just going to go to the middle of the field, and quarterback has enough time. And it's a double slant route there, double post move, and outside receiver gets inside of the defender and takes it right there for the score.
Here's Ryan Bailey, who had five field goals last week and was a lifesaver for the club. His PAT is good, and he is perfect on the season there with 10 of 10. And Texas jumps out 7-0 on a 67-yard drive. Cosby with the TD reception, a 17-yarder, 13 plays, 67 yards on the scoring drive that took 5:20 off the clock. And Texas had that big fourth and two converting in Rice territory and now leads at 7-0. Bill Landry reasons, Emily Jones with you here in FSN. McCoy, impressive start tonight. No pressure on him on that TD draws either, Gary.
Great job by the offensive line, giving him time to operate. And when he has that much time, he's a capable thrower and a guy who can read defenses. Obviously got it done there.
Corey Shepard and Tyler Smith are deep. And it is taken by the short man to the 24 and then upended at the 26-yard line as Marchbanks comes up with that on that short kick. I think it's going to be interesting, Gary, to see how teams, they're talking about the kickoff, and we showed that stat before the game about distance and average starting. How many teams, if you don't have a great kicker, will you just go ahead and kick a little shorter to get great coverage?
Well, you're going to try to get what you can, but you know, if you don't have a great kicker, that's definitely a disadvantage to you, with the rule being the ball is kicked from the 30-yard line this season.
Rice will start this one on first and 10, its own 27-yard line. Chase Clement out of Alamo Heights, Texas, the quarterback, and looking for an opening, and it is not there as Clement got stuffed on the play.
Bill, we talked to Tom Herman, who's the offensive coordinator for the Rice Owls, and the most important thing that he talked about for them doing is being consistent. Consistent positive plays with his offense here against the Longhorns, and really all season. They haven't been able to establish that all season, this consistency. And you take positive yardage plays, you put those together, it makes it a little easier for third and long, third, or get it to third and manageable, third and short. You're always behind the chains. It's not easy to operate or call a football play.
Clement here looking for his receiver and got him. It is complete to Dixon. And he is out of bounds at the 45, maybe the 46-yard line. Beasley and Griffin covering in the Texas secondary.
No huddle here. Good job here by the offense. Clement showing his ability here. Remember, he was recruited to come to Rice as an option quarterback by Ken Hatfield, and now having a chance to run this spread option offense. It's been a lot of fun for these receivers and these quarterbacks in the system now with the change in the coaching staff.
Yeah, Clement last year ran for 481 and four TDs and passed for 1,700 yards. and a ton of touchdowns. Nothing doing here as Texas again turns up the defensive heat.
You got big Derek Loki coming in there, making penetration in the front there. That zone replay does not work very well when your defensive tackles are 3 yards into the backfield. And right there, you see the tackle made behind the line of scrimmage. Lamar Houston actually on that play, doing a good job coming off his block from the edge.
Good look at Houston out of Colorado Springs. And for Rice now, second and 14, the ball at the 42. Texas coming after him, and they saw the blitz, and it is complete. And out to across the 50, the Texas territory near the 47-yard line. Beasley making the tackle.
And Jared Dillard, you're going to get the ball in his hands. He's isolated here on the left side of the screen. He's down here at the bottom, and they're going to just work on him. A little cushion there in the secondary. See the quickness that he has and the acceleration. He's a quality receiver. He's an All-American. He's a guy that's on the Bulldog watch list, so he's a guy that they definitely need to get the ball in his hands several times tonight.
They like to move him around. They have to move him around. He's seeing all kinds of double coverage and funky stuff now that he's known as an All-American after scoring 21 touchdowns last year. Third and four. Clement. Incomplete. Intended, I believe, for Dixon.
Sometimes when you run across there as a receiver and you see a different color, you slow down. Well, that's what happened here, I believe, with number seven, Dixon, coming across there.
It's Henderson, I think.
Henderson coming across there. And he saw the linebacker coming, and that ball came out hot really quick from Clement that time. There was pressure inside, again, by Lamar Houston getting back to the quarterback.
So Tommy Henderson unable to come up with that. And it's up to Luke Juice to punt it away. Cosby staying away as it's shanked out of bounds, trying to get it inside that 20, but we'll see where they mark it. Not going to be the case. Wow. That official's moving up past the 30 and around the 33-yard line.
You know, I think David Bailiff has to have the opinion of, you know, it's okay to go three downs and punt. You put the ball out there and you punt the football away and you flip the field if you can with a good punt and didn't get a great punt on this situation. But at least you challenge the offense of the Longhorns to take it a long way and only got 15 yards on that punt. So not great execution by the punt team. But I think it's okay sometimes when you play in a hostile environment, you just get the ball out of there and don't let the defense force you into negative plays.
So Texas gets it back, third possession, first and 10, the ball on the 33. This is where they started their last drive from, and they went 67 yards and 13 plays. Play action. McCoy for Sweet and incomplete. A flag was thrown, though.
Probably going to have a defensive offsides there. And you see Lima Swede, that big play capability I talked about, trying to go down the field to him. McCoy could have got this down a little bit further. He was open and had a little separation from his man.
Offside defense. 5-yard penalty. Replay, first down.
You know, Bill, I think that any offense needs to do just what the Longhorns did here, and that is have a commitment to at least throw some balls down the field. And you see the offsides there on that play to start things off. But I think throwing the ball down the field, it opens up a whole lot of other things in your running game and also in your intermediate passing game. And the Longhorns, with Greg Davis calling the offensive plays here for a number of years, certainly understands that mix.
So first and 5 on the 38 now. Charles got a big hole and then takes it outside of the 50 and across down near the 41-yard line before he is brought down. Jamal Charles, boy, he's got that second and third gear, doesn't he?
True speed, no doubt about it. When he gets the ball in his hands and he gets through a crack here, you see the backside guard and tackle pull around here, and good block in the opening there. Gets there, you see Tony Hills leading the way, and when he saw that little crease, he said, I can accelerate. Good job by the Owls of reacting, at least get a hold of him to pull him down. And
picks up 19 on the carry and sets up the Longhorns in Owl territory. First and 10 at the 42 of Rice for Texas, leading at 7-0. Cosby TD reception from Colt McCoy, the last possession. McCoy, plenty of time here. Settles in the pocket, going deep again, and it is picked off, but a flag is thrown as Rice makes the interception, and rolling into the end zone is Brandon King. We'll sort out the flag.
Well, I'm not sure who this is going to be called against, because there were both players who actually ran into each other and they were hands on each other, so this could just as easily be against the Longhorns, and this may be an interception. Take a look at it here at the end of the play. Yeah, that may be against the offense. Looks like the receiver had his hands in there trying to get the ball out. trying to be the defender in that case.
The interception is good if it stands. The ball never hit the ground. It's against the Owls.
That's Billy Pittman, who's back in the lineup for the for the Longhorns, trying to get on that play, and they're going to call this against Rice, which negates a huge play in the secondary. That was a nicely covered, and actually a very good play by Brandon King.
At Texas, by the way, they well documented some of their off-the-field problems, but they got three players back for this game who had been suspended for the first three: Henry Melton, Sergio Kendall, and also Billy Pittman that Gary just mentioned. Let's send it down to Emily Jones.
Even though that call did not go David Bailiff's way, he was still very proud of his team. Instead of taking his frustrations out on the official, instead he decided to encourage his team, said that's a way to play, play hard, keep playing like that. We'll get those calls eventually.
Thanks, Emily. It is first and 10 at the 27 now for Texas. Three wideouts to the left. And with the football, John Chiles. We were told we would see Chiles, the freshman quarterback out of Mansfield Summit in the Dallas area. And they want to get him working. He is the backup quarterback, and that's his first play of college football.
Yeah, kind of a slash player, too. He's got great abilities, you talk about, Bill, and get him in the game and get his first snap under him and send Colt McCoy out to the outside. And Longhorn fans, they know he was in there because they're cheering for him. He's an exceptional athlete, one that they think has a really bright future.
Second and 10 at the 27 as Childs back to the sideline and McCoy in the shotgun. Here they come after Colt McCoy. Under pressure, and it is out of bounds. Swede, the receiver, and Ja'Cory Shepherd, the cover man, junior out of Lufkin, Texas.
I think the Owls, they definitely need to bring some pressure. They need to bring it several different ways. If you just rush a four-man line here against the Texas Longhorns, they're too big up front to, and they'll give too much time to their quarterback to complete those throws. But bring a little pressure like they did that time. Did a nice job of forcing out of the pocket there. Craig Daybar, the defensive coordinator, who's on the field, and Coach Reisbach, who's also up in the booth. They've got co-coordinators defensively for the Rice Owls, trying to change it up here to see what Colt McCoy is seeing.
Third and 10. Charles, 7 carries, 46 yards so far, with 4:55 to go in this first quarter here in Austin. McCoy across the middle and incomplete, trying to connect that time with Nate Jones.
Looked like Nate kind of stopped on that route. Looked like he went up and came across. Didn't have to make a lot of effort to get into the middle of the field. I think Colt McCoy thought that he was going to come more across the field, but I don't think he does so. Kind of slows down. He does get a jam there a little bit about the 10 yards down the field, which is a penalty, but maybe that's what kind of threw him off and didn't allow him to continue that route.
That'll set up Ryan Bailey for what should be a 44-yard field goal attempt. Remember, Bailey last week hit 5 field goals in that win. He's 7 of 9 on the year. His longest was from 42, so he surpassed that. Shipley, the holder. The kick, it is long enough. And it is good. So Bailey, a big confidence boost with his performance last week when Texas really needed those three-pointers. And he tacks on 3 more to make it 10-0. And let's send it down to that scholarship with his work so far. And a 5-play, 40-yard drive that stalled, and a 43-yard field goal that matches his career best. He had a 43-yarder last season.
I wonder if moms, like most moms, do keep those letters that their kids write to them.
Oh, I'm sure.
That would be fun to look at.
Letters? Somebody does something other than email?
Email?
Last time you got a letter from anybody. Here's the kickoff, and the Owls having trouble with the bounce on the pickup. Tyler Smith, he's at the 15, and upended shy of the 20-yard line. And Rice, after that squib kick, will have it first and 10 from the 19.
Well, you've got to stay committed to what you're doing, and Chase Clement coming back out, running the offense, and the spread offense is what they do, and that's what they do best. You've got the three receivers on the field and the one tight end in the back.
First and 10 at the 19 for Chase Clement, 6'1", 208-pound junior. Finds Dillard, looking for some room, made one miss, and Dillard quickly scampers up across the 35, knocked out, I guess, just shy of there at the 34-yard line.
And Deion Beasley, who's got to actually start this ball game tonight. Brandon Foster injured himself in warm-ups tonight, pulled a quad, and so out there trying to defend Jarrett Dillard. And Jarrett Dillard showing he's got some quicks, and he eludes Deion Beasley on the outside for a nice game.
You see Dillard, 28th straight game now with two or more catches. First and 10 for the Owls at the 35. Giving the defense at least a little breather here. Clement again goes outside this time and completes it. And Palmer makes the defensive play after the pass complete to Tommy Henderson. Henderson had come in with 12 receptions for 91 yards. Junior out of Wichita Falls, Tommy Henderson.
Well, this is execution. I talked about Rice being able to do that, and that is get positive plays and string those together. That's what Tom Herman would like to see. The offensive coordinator for the Owls would like to see from his offense put a few good plays together.
Second down and six now for the Owls. Texas up 10-0. Cosby, 17-yard TD pass reception, and Bailey a career matching best 43-yard field goal. And this one's handed off to Hill, and nothing doing there. Texas defense not letting him get outside at all. In on the play, Roderick McElroy.
Now, I tell you what, this is a play that Texas runs, and they run it to perfection. And so this Texas defense, guess what, Bill? They know quite a bit. They know how to handle it. They know how to defend it. Good job at the point of attack, not letting that edge be one there on the outside and nowhere for the running back to go whatsoever. And Justin Hill is just bottled up before he can get started.
Yeah, Amari Houston, maybe pardon me, with a big stop there. Houston. And now Texas sees Rice in a third and 10, and the Longhorn fans start to get a little rowdy here. I'd like to welcome our viewers who've been watching the Texas Tech-Oklahoma State game, and congratulations to the Cowboys, who are the Big 12 leaders, winning the first conference game of the season, and a wild one in Stillwater. Here it is Texas and Rice, and Texas with a 10-0 lead. Bill Land, Gary Reasons, Emily Jones with you on FSN. The Owls will be forced to kick it away on a 4th and 10. Texas, a TD pass from McCoy to Cosby, and a 43-yard field goal from Bailey, and leading at 10-0. Here's the punter, Luke Juice, again. And deep is Cosby for University of Texas. Got it off. It's a dandy. Fair catch at the 10-yard line. And that's where Texas will operate. 2:03 to go in the first quarter. Speaking of that Texas Tech-Oklahoma State game, obviously a big game. Everybody trying to get some momentum. Oklahoma State, though, particularly after losing to Troy last week, that gives them some real plus as they head on into conference play.
Kind of a good measuring stick for the Cowboys, being able to defend their home turf at home against a feisty team. It's always Texas Tech, and they're able to score points at will. A lot of scoring in that ball game, and they outlasted Texas Tech in that football game. And glad to have everyone back with us here for this ball game. It's a pretty good ball game early on. Rice had an opportunity on the first drive by Texas. They fumbled, Jamal Charles fumbled the opening handoff of the ball game for him, but Rice did not convert.
Here's Charles trying to stretch it. Scampers out of bounds near the 15-yard line. That 54-yard punt puts Texas in a bit of a hole. And maybe a second down and still long coming up for the University of Texas. First down markers brought to you by Overstock.com. Your entire order ships for just $2.95 at Overstock.com. Live better with Overstock.com. It's all about the O. I call it second and six for the Longhorns. McCoy completes this one out near the 20-yard line, and reception made by Nate Jones.
Bill, one of the things for this Texas offense is the revamp of that offensive line, and you've got to be able to protect the quarterback. Take a look at these guys and what they're doing. It's a three-man rush, doing a decent job to allow Colt McCoy to get a quick hitch out to the outside, and take a look at what happens when they rush the quarterback. And allow that quarterback to throw the football on timing like that, you're doing a pretty good job. It's a growing situation, though, for these linemen. Had three starters from a year ago, drafted to the NFL, so a lot of changes up there, and they've just got to gel together.
First and 10, Longhorns. McCoy, great protection. Going deep, and Charles could not hang on. He had a couple of receptions coming in, and last year caught 18 balls for 183 yards and a number two pick on the all-conference squad.
Nobody in his kitchen back there. Colt McCoy standing back there all day with a nice, easy, smooth throw, and this should have been an easy catch by Jamal Charles, who has great speed, as everyone knows, and he gets behind the defense, no doubt about that. And not even fair. He's back there 5 yards beyond him, so should have caught that football and run it in for a score.
Yeah, Charles was second in the 100 meters in Big 12 track and field championships last spring. He can fly, but he's got to find the handle, both from the receiving end and the running end. Speaking of that, how about the mitts there on the grab by Nate Jones? It's time for Dr. Pepper game. Michael, boy, he continues to build his Heisman credentials. People can say it's too early. Well, not for guys like that who've got some history already.
He's got some resume. There's no doubt about that.
Third and 5 for Texas. This one is batted down by that Rice front line. 97, Cameron Thompson, big freshman out of Cedar Hill, Texas.
A good job by the Rice defense. Third down, stopped Texas. Bring the punt team on here for the Longhorns. You see the defense here. Good thing that you need to do is if you're not getting or you're double team, go ahead and get your hands up. And it's a big Cameron Thompson, a freshman, getting to start this ball game for Rice. Gets his hands up there. Good job knocking it away.
As a result, McCoy is now 9 of 14 for 76 yards. Shepherd is the deep man for the Owls. Gerland's punt takes a Texas roll as they get away from it and goes inside the 30 before it goes out of bounds near the 28-yard line. Well, Texas leading it 10-0 and also dominating in total yards, 123-27 here with just 48 seconds to go in this first quarter. A 42-yard punt that time, and the Owls will have it first and 10 from their own 28.
Well, this Rice football team comes in here, Bill, and this is a year of change for them starting this season. They've got a new head coach and David Bailiff with the program, and a lot of people may not know David, but he's had a very good career as a former head coach at Southwest Texas State, which is now Texas State University. He had a good run up at TCU with Dennis Franchione there, so he's a very accomplished football coach, and I think he's going to do a very good job with the Rice program overall down there. He's brought in a staff that's somewhat inexperienced at the Division I level, but I think overall he's brought in good people, and they know how to get things done. And they've got a system, I think, that they'll be able to recruit to down at Rice, and that's always a challenge. Coach Hatfield, who was down there, Ken Hatfield, recruited to the option. That's kind of the players that David Bailiff currently has on his offense to be able to roll out there. But as he starts his recruiting campaign and getting his type of players for the offense that he'd like to run, I think that Rice is going to shock some people, and I think it's a really good fit for Conference USA.
Yeah, and he looks at Rice as not restrictions academically. He looks at his opportunities and chances and things to do great things at that institution. The pass is complete to Taylor Wardlaw. Wardlaw, the tight end, a sophomore from Grapevine, Texas, just outside of DFW Airport, and he makes the reception. This Rice, 34.
Yeah, this Rice team is young, as you see the reception here by Wardlaw, and they started 10 true freshmen in this ball. So they started 10 true freshmen in this season. They've had 5 redshirt freshmen as well play, so 15 total freshmen playing so far for Rice this season.
That wraps up the first quarter here. Welcome back. Texas leading as we go to the second quarter, 10-0. The only touchdown, a 17-yard TD pass from Colt McCoy to Quan Cosby.
Get things started here early for Texas. Getting the ball down there. Does a nice job getting it in there. And more importantly, taking that second possession offensively and putting points on the board.
Bailey added a field goal later from 43. And we start the second quarter with a Rice football on a 3rd and 4 at the 34 of the Owls. Chase Clement, the quarterback for Rice, trailing 10-0. And complete, incomplete. Rule, and
he called
it complete. And at the 44-yard line, a bobble Deion Beasley was covering, but it is ruled a reception for Dixon.
Yeah, he bobbled it, but he had both arms underneath the football, and it bounced off his forearms. I think we'll see it here at the end of the play. Good protection up front. The quarterback steps up into it, and he bobbles it there on the end, but his forearms are squarely underneath that football.
When did it become ball security instead of just hang on to the ball? Everything is ball security now.
Yeah, I think they got to review this play.
All right, we will have a video review of it here to make sure that stands.
Ruling on the field stands. First down.
There you see Big 12 instant replays this season. 33 reviewed, 15 overturned. Average time 121. That's probably over 1 minute because of that 15-minute stoppage we had on that triple overtime game down at a College Station between Texas A&M and Fresno State.
Yeah, we had kind of a unique
that was wild.
Review that time and in the three overtimes. It was an interesting ball game.
But they did get it right, which was what was the important thing in that game. So Rice moves the chains, first and 10 of the 45. Clement is 6 of 8 for 68 yards in the air now. First minute of the second quarter. And he'll keep the football. Got some wheels, and he slides across the 50. And it'll be marked down near the 48-yard line. Chase Clement.
You know, this defense, Bill, for Texas, it has changed as well. In the secondary in particular, those guys are really new back there. The only one with really experience back there is Marcus Griffin, who's playing free safety, the leading tackler. And, you know, overall, this team has changed quite a bit over the last 2 to 3 seasons with this football team. A lot of players being drafted and gone from take the 2005 season where they won the national championship in Longhorns. This team is vastly different. They've had to retool and rebuild and insert new players into the mix.
Second down and 3 at the 48 of Rice. That was the first positive running play that the Owls have had this evening. This one, a quick hitter to Dillard, and he hangs on and should have the first down. Yes, he's across the 45-yard line where Deion Beasley was covering. And, Gary, you mentioned players, and, I mean, when you lose this, Texas fans, temper your enthusiasm a little bit for wanting to know why you aren't winning by such wide margins.
Well, this is from 05, 06, those drafts, and now you take a look at 07. That's what I'm talking about, the defensive backs are Michael Griffin, Aaron Ross, a couple of top defensive picks in the draft. They're gone from this secondary, and they've had to retool back there. And it's kind of been a slow process, but they feel like they've got the athletes in place. They've got the guys up front with Frank Okem and Derek Loki there, and capable linebackers. But the secondary is a chance where they really need to make some strides, and they've got great athletes out there. They just need experience on the field.
9 players making NFL rosters off last year's Texas team. All right, Clement stopped on that play for a loss. It is 2nd and 12. Glad to have you aboard here on Kyocera's College Football Saturday. Rice in 6th-ranked Texas. Bill Land, Gary Reasons, Emily Jones with you. And we've got 13:09 to go, second quarter. And a flag thrown here. Rice trailing 10-0 and facing a 2nd and 12 with a 46.
81.
And that'll push it back a bit.
5-yard penalty.
It's on Dillard.
2nd down.
Didn't catch it earlier today on FSN. Oklahoma State beating Texas Tech in the Big 12 Conference opener, 49-45, on a day where Graham Harrell threw for 645 yards and lost as the Texas Tech quarterback.
Wow.
What a wild one today in Stillwater. Now 2nd and 17 at the 49. Clement on the rollout. Throws it, nearly picked off, trying to go to Dixon. Beasley was covered.
Nice job by Beasley being there, right in tight coverage around on the outside. Torn Dixon can't pull the football in because Beasley is right there. But take a look at Clement here on the outside. Good protection, good job of picking up the blitz there on the outside. He zings it out there. Thought he might have a chance, but too good a coverage there by Beasley on the outside.
And we should note Beasley getting the start tonight, Gary, because of an injury to Brandon Foster, who had an interception and a touchdown last week against Central Florida. Foster aggravated a quad strain during the pregame and is not going to play tonight. So Beasley, he's been in a lot of action early on.
Texas uses their second time out here in the ballgame. Used one earlier in the first quarter on a fourth down decision, and now here on defense, he's intercepted.
Welcome you back, Bill Land, Gary Reasons, Emily Jones with you. Texas crowd up roaring now. It is a 3rd and 17 for Rice from the 49-yard line of the Owls. And Clement back to pass, in trouble, got creamed as he unloads it, and it is knocked away out of bounds.
Speed rush on the outside by Eddie Jones, defensive end, coming into the ballgame here for the Longhorns and not allowing quarterback Clement. Watch the top of your screen, folks. Going to get right around the offensive tackle and get there, hit the quarterback. There's 3 Longhorns meeting there right at the point. Beasley's doing a pretty good job here keeping up with Jared Dillard here on the outside.
I'll tell you what, Clement was fortunate to make that accurate of a throw with the pressure and the way he got hit. Dillard actually had a chance. So, they'll now kick it away. And a horrible punt. And Texas is going to get unbelievable field position.
I think they marked it 1 yard.
That is going to be it. 1 yard.
I don't think I've ever seen a 1 yard punt before. And David Bailiff, I'm not sure he's seen one either. He's talking to his punter about that. Sometimes it happens, it goes off your foot here. And he's probably dropping the point of the ball on his foot like a lot of punters do in this area. But this one just spins off the left side of his foot, and he put his head down immediately.
He's like, what happened? Wow. Tough one for Luke Juice, the senior from Houston.
And he's had 15 punts inside the 20-yard line. He's really done a good job of that this season. Just had one go like a shank.
So Texas gets it right at midfield. First down. And complete, juggling with Swede. He's at the 25. Lyman Swede will score. No, he stepped out of bounds. Well, one official signaling touchdown, and another is signaling out at the 2 or 3 yard line. I think he stepped out of bounds.
Why would he step out of bounds?
I don't know, but the official immediately ruled it.
Well, watch Ja'Cory Shepherd, the cornerback here. He actually goes inside, kind of stumbles a little bit, and I think Lyman Sweet thought he was going to get hit, but he's running to the edge of the sideline here, and he's to run straight up the field. And does he step out? He's looking down right there. I think he does step right out on the white.
Well, that official is right there. There's no way he missed that. And fans are seeing it on the vision here, Ed.
Yeah, Sweet's got a smile on his face, or he knows he should have had a big touchdown after that catch, because he just outran the secondary for the Owls.
So they're going to review it.
Video confirmed, ruling on the field. First down, Texas.
The fans are like, well, wait a minute. They didn't know to react there, did they? They go, well, they're giving us a first down. We want a touchdown.
Well, they showed it on the Jumbotron here, the Megatron, whatever they call this big monster of a screen here. It's big.
Godzilla-tron.
Yeah, they showed it here for sure, and the fans saw it, so they knew he stepped out. So there was no complaining when the official finally came out with that ruling.
Saw McCoy's numbers so far this evening, 10 of 15 for 124, and it's first and goal from the 2 yard line now for Texas. Charles. He dances his way into the end zone. Jamal Charles gets his fourth touchdown of the season, his first of the night, and Texas leads it 16 to nothing. And that 1 yard punt came back to bite the Owls.
Matt, really did here. You just get your offense down here in great field position, give it to your number one tailback who leads the Big 12 Conference in rushing, and get behind a powerful offensive line. And an offensive line is really improving and giving him enough room to work with. And it has overpowered the Rice defense. With 2 yards to go. Pretty good numbers there, getting Jamal Charles scoring 8 straight ball games.
So Bailey on for the PAT, trying to make it 17-0. And this one is good, and Texas does so. So a 13-second drive, if you will. 12-19 to go in the half. Texas leads it 17-0. Texas to kick it off here. As the Longhorns, with Charles getting the touchdown and his fourth of the season. After he had that fumble on the opening possession and the drop on what would have been a TD on a long pass, it's going to feel a little better there, Gary.
Yeah, 1 yard punt just kind of set it all up for him. Jamal Charles being the benefactor of nice turn of events there.
You better thank Lima Sweet for stepping out of bounds, too. Because Lima scored, that was my touchdown. Downed in the end zone, and we'll take a Dr. Pepper game. Thank you, Michael. And the woes continue for Charlie Weiss and crew.
And it just shows you the deficiencies in the poll system early in the season, too.
Yes.
Penn State number 10 against the Michigan team that's really depleted. I know they're playing spirited football after their early season loss.
Clement keeps it here on a first and 10 from the 20-yard line. You know, and Gary, coming back to those polls, more and more people are saying, now, you know what? let's not have any official polls until like at least October. You would still have groups out there. But if you don't do anything officially, I think it gives everybody a much more fair chance to at least start where they really belong in October.
And it's really hard to move up. You know, things just kind of stay in status quo ahead of you. There's no way for you to move up, and that's what some teams feel like, that they're slotted poorly or wrongly at the start of the season, and it really affects how things end up for you in a bowl situation.
Third and short now for the Rice Owls as Texas trying to take control here, up 17-0 with 11:29 to go in the second quarter.
You know, Rice does what a lot of teams do. They come to the line of scrimmage, they survey the defense, they look to the sideline to get the signals from the coaching staff, and they don't have to be in a really big hurry to get things called.
Third and two, and big pop, and Casey, the freshman quarterback.
Yeah, Chase Clement was actually on the outside. He was a wide receiver, so James Casey came into the ballgame. He's the quarterback, and out here is your starting quarterback. So they put the little tandem into the ball game here, kind of like we saw that Texas did earlier in the ball game with Colt McCoy bringing in John Childs as well. So kind of a dual-headed monster there. Just give the defense something to think about. And Clement now back behind center.
Casey's from Hazel, Texas, and he's a big fella, 6'4". Clement will pump fake, dodge the traffic, and now comes out firing the other side and complete. And he gets it to Casey as Palmer makes the stop.
Now, he wanted to go to Patrick Randolph on the near sideline on the pump and go, but nothing taken there by the Texas defense. Good job in the secondary of holding back and not biting on that first pump fake. But Clement doing a nice job of going to the other sideline and finding an open receiver.
As Casey makes the reception there, and now Rice first and 10 near midfield at the 48 officially. Clement rolls out, getting away from the pressure again, and it is intercepted by Texas at the 29-yard line. And Marcus Griffin, the senior from Austin Bowie, makes the INT.
What a nice play on the football by Griffin there. At the very last second, he comes up, and he just elevates himself above the receiver. In that case, Jarrett Dillard could not get this football. Watch the elevation here that Griffin does and pulls that ball away. Tremendous job there. That's actually Patrick Randolph, the potential receiver there, not able to get that football. Marcus Griffin going up, making a heck of an interception there on the football.
And Texas gets it back via the turnover.
Now, his game, Bill, has really stepped up. You know, his brother drafted the NFL last year. Great defensive back. And Marcus Griffin is really putting some pretty good stuff together here for his senior campaign.
First and 10, the ball at the 29-yard line now. Play action, Colt McCoy. Plenty of protection, and this one is complete at the 40-yard line as Texas putting it up in the air. And Ebonia comes up with it, and Texas will have a first down in Rice territory at the 36-yard line.
Obanyaya does a nice job of just running down the field. And he's normally a tailback for this football team, but he's on the outside, and he gets around the edge, and not going to be able to catch him. Got good speed there. Just watch Obanyaya come down the field from out of the backfield. Nobody's running with him, and nice job concentrating on the football and pulling it in.
Obanyaya, a 35-yard play. Chris is a junior from Missouri City, Texas. Came in with 3 receptions, had run 13 times for 37 yards. McCoy nearly had a collision in the backfield before handing that ball off to Obanyaya. And let's send it down to Emily Jones.
LSAT, and his nickname is the team nerd.
Well, he was anything but that on that pass reception. McCoy, going down, throws the ball to the sideline. Reigns had him wrapped up.
Well, going to be a sack here on McCoy. He can't get the ball away. They actually called him down there on the field. Good job by Brian Reigns, who's done a good job for Rice all season. He's an explosive linebacker. He's their leading tackler, and he's the elite out. What he did in the offseason for Rice is really impressive. He led their offseason program. He's the top performer in getting power and strength, and he's really turned his football game up. He's a leader out there on defense and making a lot of plays for his team.
So now Texas faced with a third and 19. They lead it 17-0.
Ball is on the 45-yard line of the Owls. And McCoy out of the shotgun again. Steps up this time and finds Sweet. He spins, but he is tackled at the 35 and falls through the 34-yard line. Slime a Swede as Anderson makes the stop. Gary Anderson, the tackler for the Owls.
Lima Swede, big receiver, easy to find for Colt McCoy coming across the field. Underneath route here, just going to get behind the linebackers and catch that football and try to spin to make plays, but Anderson makes a nice tackle there. So fourth and long here, looks like Texas, they're going to line up for a field goal attempt. Or
Bailey is out there, and
52-yarder.
Well, he matched his career best with a 43 earlier. So Bailey, just see what kind of leg the junior from here in Austin has. Went to Anderson High School. Ryan Bailey pulled it up from 52, and it is long enough, and it is good. How about that? Ryan Bailey, a 52-yard field goal, and Texas now leads it 20-0. Grats all the way around for Ryan Bailey, the 6'2 junior, Texas 20, Rice. Catching DeMarco Zach when people start firing the questions his direction.
He hangs pretty good.
Yeah, he does very well in there. He can take the heat.
Defend himself, yeah. No doubt about that.
Texas with a 20-0 lead after Bailey's 52-yard field goal, his career best, and the Longhorns now will kick it off. Hunter Lawrence for the kickoff, and the return by the Rice Owls, Ja'Cory Shepherd, is just shy of the 20-yard line. On the 19.
Yeah, the athletes they put for University of Texas on their kick teams is really tremendous. The speed they put on there, it's kind of like the kick returners. They got something sweet on them, like a little marmalade or something, where they're able to go down and make a tackle. And just going down, getting
That's
something
right.
sweet that you can hit on.
Get after it. The Owls will have it first and 10 from the 19-yard line. .736 to go in the first half. The Owls, if this thing's going to stay under control, they need to get on the board, Gary.
Yeah, they definitely do. They had an opportunity early in the ballgame after the fumble by Charles. Did not convert. And, you know, talking about positive plays, that's what you need to do is string plays together. And Rice simply has not been able to do that consistently.
That was intended for Patrick Randolph again, the freshman out of Tuscaloosa, Alabama. First down markers brought to you by Overstock.com. Save up to 70% on brand name products. Live better with Overstock.com. It's all about the up. Coming out of the gun again. Second and 10 from the 19-yard line. Hands off the football. And nothing doing for Justin Hill as Texas. They've just stuffed that running game this entire first half.
Well, the run game is not going to be there, I don't think, for Rice tonight, Bill. They've got their top two tailbacks out with injuries, with knee injuries, and Justin Hill playing a lot in this ballgame, a true freshman. And tough defense they're going against. A powerful, speedy defense by the Longhorns. The linebackers just scrape so well. The defensive linemen are so agile.
Roderick McElroy that time, bursting through. Rice, 13 running plays, minus 10 yards. They've thrown for 88 on 8 of 14 completed. They've also had an INT. And flag thrown here.
False start. 72 offense. 5-yard penalty. Still third down.
I mean, Justin Hill, the freshman tailback, 5 carries, minus 16 yards. It's not the kind of stats you want to build in your
career. Well, they keep running the same play, the zone read, and guess what? Texas has read it well every time, and he keeps losing yardage on that same play. So not working for Rice. They need to find another play in the run game that's going to give him some positive yardage. Now, this is a play where Chase Clement does not want to make a mistake. An interception here would be deadly. Just don't get anything open. Go ahead and throw it away and punt the football.
And third and 18. He goes to Knox out of the backfield. Texas keeping it all in front of him, and it'll be another punting situation for Luke Juice, who
has averaged 23 yards on his three punts after that one-yarder the last time. Let's see what kind of confidence he kicks with this time.
You know, Rice not really getting a whole lot of offense going in this football game. The Texas defense doing pretty well. Only 87 yards of total offense for Rice in this football game here in the first half. So overall, the Texas defense has not allowed any big plays by the Owls, and doing a good job there forcing the punting situation again.
Juiced is back on his own 6-yard line as Texas put a little pressure on, but they don't get it. Cosby got to field it at the 41. Dances to make a couple miss for a bunch of Owls. Finally knock him down at the 47-yard line of Texas. A great field position for the Longhorns with a 20-0 lead. To 20-0 over Rice. Now let's check out which student athlete is getting it done on the Dr. Pepper Honor Rolls. Well, there's a bunch of guys that qualify from these two schools. Luke Barber, kinesiology and managerial studies major for Rice, lineman, and Frank Okam, a 4.0 GPA, four-time member of the UT Honor Roll, and he and his tag team partner on that defensive line, Derek Loki, both 4.0s last spring. And there's a very intelligent group of players taking the field tonight for both clubs.
No doubt about that.
First and 10 at the 48. McCoy steps up out of the pocket and touchdown, Texas. Nobody stepping out of bounds this time. Lima Swede in the end zone. So Swede gets the TD. Said, hey, I was owed one. His second of the season, his first of the night. 53 yards on the play from Colt McCoy.
Lima Swede just going to run and go straight down the field, folks, and just got too much speed, too much power, running away from the secondary. He's got over-the-top help that are going to get him short, and Lima Swede is going to get behind him. A little trip there by the defender, but nonetheless, that ball is going to be completed with the separation that Lima Swede has, and thankful for that touchdown because he should have had one earlier. He gave to his good buddy, though.
Well, they're talking about spreading the wealth here as far as running, passing, get more people involved. So I'm sure that's how Linus will explain it later on to Jamal Charles. Bailey had a big night already with a couple of field goals, including a 43 and 52-yarder. Bangs it through on the PAT, and it is now Texas in complete control, 27-0.
Well, we talked about him getting back in the lineup, kind of a tweaked ankle last week in that football game against Central Florida. Not showing any signs of any injury here with pure speed. And I think he's one of the top receivers in the country, Bill. And there's some really great receivers, I think, in the conference. And you take a look at the career passes here for Colt McCoy and how he's moving up the charts. Pretty impressive for his first 16 games.
Yeah, outstanding with that group of quarterbacks there. You know, we were talking early on that this is kind of the year of the wide receiver in the Big 12 Conference. And you got Swede, you got Bowman up there at Oklahoma State. You can go just down roster on player after player. Missouri's got those big tight ends that are really wideouts. You name it, and every school's got a couple of great ones.
Yeah, you got Oklahoma, who's got a great receiver up there.
How about Kelly?
Yeah, Malcolm Kelly's a tremendous athlete. And
Glacius.
Young man Crabtree, who's doing a great job at Texas Tech. So a lot of receivers to really watch out for as the season unfolds here, especially if we get into conference play in the Big 12.
Rice Owls, conference play next week with Southern Miss and CUSA. Texas will have Kansas State in its Big 12 opener. On the return, Shepherd about the 33-yard line before he is stopped, and Rice will get possession there. We'll send it to you. You see what David Bailiff has got playing for him there, and academics were a big part of his situation at Texas State, and he moves into a place that is known for great academics. He's trying to get that football up to that level after they had a bowl season a year ago in the 1 year that Coach Graham was there.
Yeah, and Emily's talking about the academic progress report. Well, actually, the football team is number one in the bowl subdivision category for college football of how they rank in that academic progress report. So good stuff there academically for Rice. And got to put it all together and win football games, though, sometimes, too. And going against the Big 12 slate like they've had early in the season here, Bill, the three consecutive Big 12 teams is not something I think that David Baylor, when he first got the job, said, hey, that's what I would have liked to start with.
Yeah, they lost to Baylor, then last week to Texas Tech, and now trailing here to the Texas Longhorns. And Clement keeps and gets the first down as he goes to the 42-yard line. And Eric Jackson, the strong safety, a senior from Cedar Hill out of Duncanville High School in the Dallas area there in Texas, says he makes the tackle, and that'll move the chains for the Rice Owls with 5:17 to go in this first half.
Well, they've shown glimpses of being able to move the football here on the Longhorns. Chase Clement doing a good job there with his feet coming around the edge. He's thrown the football well and really hadn't made too many major mistakes, but overall it's just the talent that the defense has right now with the Longhorns is just superior to what is out there for the Owls.
On the first of 10, Clement fires and out of bounds, trying to hit Marcus Knox, the sophomore out of Houston. Beasley there covering again. Well, you see tonight why Texas has dominated this series. And last year they won 52-7. They've won 8 in a row and 36 of the last 37 times these two have met.
Tremendous accomplishment for what they've been able to do. Old Southwest Conference foes and haven't beaten... Rice has not beaten Texas since 1994. They lost in Houston 19-14.
Second and 10 for the Owls here. Clement in trouble. Oh, brought down. And coming through, Frank Ocam, the 6'5 senior out of Dallas. 320-pounder from Lake Highlands High School. We showed you his academic prowess. He played a little football, too.
He's like a runaway freight train here. Watch from the right side of the quarterback here. Bingo, there's a big fella. Look out. Turn back into him. And Frank doing a nice job in there. He's a leader up there. He's one of those guys that anchors the defense. When you can start with your inside-out players like Frank Ocam, Derek Loki, Roy Miller, inside defensively, you're going to have a lot of success as the season goes along.
All-conference pick, Big 12 last year. Whistle stopping this one with a flag.
72 offense. Five
Bobby Hios.
Still third down.
The culprit. And push it now to third and a mile. Call it 26. Wow.
Third and 26.
At the 31-yard line of the Owls.
And there's a sack for defense, what they've done here over since 1999. Texas moving up the ranks there, 311 sacks. It's getting to the quarterback quite a bit.
Watch out. Bang. Clement stuffed on the sack. Houston comes through again. Lamar Houston.
Yeah, he's got a pretty good motor. Houston does. We saw him earlier in the ball game coming off the edge and making a good clean hit on the quarterback. Didn't get there for the sack, but this time around the outside again and just running around the left tackle, Luke Barber. Chase Clement's got to have a little clock that goes off in his head, and it's got to be a little faster here at the University of Texas because these defensive ends are athletic and fast.
And Juiced will set up inside his 5 for the punt. Cosby at his own 40 for Texas for the return. 3:33 remaining in the first half. Skies this one. And Cosby gets away, and it is taken there by Rice at the 35. So Texas with a 27-0 lead, and Trias gets a 12-yard pickup on a pass play from McCoy to Cosby and has it first and 10 at the 47 now. And this one again to Cosby, and he rolls inside the 35 down near the 33-yard line as Brian Raines makes the tackle.
Cosby having a pretty good night here, Bill. Fifth catch of the evening, I believe, and just moving down the field. Very comfortable with Colt McCoy and good precision routes coming inside. Right on the scene there before the safety can come over and make the play.
Texas with TDs from Cosby, Charles, and Swede, and a pair of field goals from Bailey to lead it 27-0. And here is Charles shedding tacklers down to the 25-yard line. Brian Raines, again, the stopper for Rice. 2:39 to go here in this first half. Remember, Texas did burn a couple of timeouts. They've got one remaining.
Inside little zone play there. You bring your backside guard and tackle around and get the tailback in there behind those big fellas. And these guys are going to move some people. They're big, they're agile, they're athletic. That's what they demand for the Texas Longhorn offensive line, to be able to come around, run that zone replay and the trap play as well.
First and 10 of the 24 for quarterback Colt McCoy, the sophomore from Tuscola, Texas, Jim Ned High School. And McCoy, look right, goes left. Shipley cannot hang on. Jordan Shipley, the junior from Burnett, Texas, with Gary Anderson marking him. Shipley had all caught all kinds of injuries.
Well, first of all, take a look at the quarterback. He's got plenty of time to throw the football. He's wanting to go up here, but he's got that cover, but he throws it back down to the left and shifted. Good play here by Anderson at the end, though. Getting his hand in there between the receiver's hands and knocking that ball out. Ball was right on the money by Colt McCoy. If Anderson had not gotten his hand in there, it certainly would have been a touchdown.
Maybe father, some football player up there for the Piggies. Shipley's a guy who's had all kinds of injuries. Had four receptions last week for 47 yards, coming back from Central Florida, and also ran a couple times for 12. This time, they throw it to number 9, and that is Nate Jones. And he spins all the way down to the 5-yard line. Jones.
Take a look at it here, and there's going to be Nate Jones right there, and he's going to run down the field and kind of work with his quarterback. Come inside, a little delay right there, and he got the lineman coming out. Good job of execution there, and just kind of a scissors play, kind of a screen play to the inside, and a lot of teams will run that very much to the outside with the wide receivers. Picking up blocks from Nate Jones, the beneficiary of some good blocking from his big guys.
Yeah, Charlie Tanner, number 52, got a good one in there. Sophomore from here in Austin out of Anderson High. And Texas has it first and goal from the 5-yard line. And Charles weaving and darting and into the end zone. T.D. Longhorn. Charles, his second tonight, his fifth of the season.
Now Jamal Charles now 65 yards, I believe, rushing on the night, and a couple of touchdowns to his credit. Just a downhill play, and he cuts back against the grain, just reading the line. Zone read there as well.
Jamal Charles, last year led him in rushing with 831 yards, came in with 399 yards through the first three games, over 100 in each game. And tonight he's got his second score here, as Bailey knocks through the PAT, and Texas makes it 34-0. Charles has got 67 yards. Glad to have you with us here at Darrell K. Royal, Texas Memorial Stadium in Austin. Will Asbury reasons them with Jones as Texas put a spanking on the Owls, 34-0. And the kickoff goes to near the 1-yard line, and Smith jumped over one defender and ends up carrying it out to about the 28-yard line. Remind you to do here with three timeouts remaining, first and 10 on their own 29. Gotta be a little careful here if you don't get something going. Texas may get their hand on the football again. Hill is the running back. Gets the carry. And Justin Hill to the near the 35-yard line. So shows you which direction they're headed.
You know, last week, Bill, Longhorn fans were really thinking that Texas would go out to Central Florida and just kind of have their way with that football team out there. And Roger Lear and his troops, they're a pretty good outfit.
Yeah.
They're a pretty good football team. They've got good talent out there, and they played very well in that football game. There's an interception here.
Pass deflected at the line and then intercepted. There's a penalty. McElroy came up with the INT. There's a flag thrown. Texas starting to rush on with the offense, and now they found out they are going to get the ball, I believe.
Illegal formation, offense, decline, first down.
Roderick McElroy with his first interception, a sophomore, 6'2", 230 from Hallsville, Texas.
He's going to get tipped at the line of scrimmage here. Big number 94 gets his hand on there and tips that football away for him. So Thomas Marshall making a nice play there for the Longhorns, getting the ball up in the air for Roderick McElroy to pick it off and get it back in the hands of the offense. And as you said, Bill, you want to be careful if you're Rice to not make a play here that the ball go back to Texas, because they'll put more points up here before half. They got plenty of time to work with a minute and 12 left to go.
So Texas, a chance to hit that 40 mark. Remember, they have one timeout remaining. McCoy going for that 6 right now. Swede, touchdown, Texas again. Wow, what a performance. McCoy, Swede, that whole offense clicking now.
What a great throw by Colt McCoy. Puts his ball on the outside, and it's on the sideline. And the only one who's going to catch this is his receiver. He puts it kind of behind him into the outside. No chance for the defender to even make a play on the football. This ball is an easy throw, an easy catch here for this receiver, and gets it up there very nicely. He knows where Lymus is going. He gets him turned, and just very well executed.
So Bailey comes on.
You see what Colt McCoy's seeing there. He's got one-on-one coverage, and when you've got a receiver with the skills and the ability that Lymus Sweet has, you need to throw it up there for him, and he's going to pull it down most of the time.
Sweet gets his second touchdown. McCoy, his third TD pass of the night. He's at 295 yards. Off comes to Rice, and this is Smith again. Finds some room, 35, the 40. Tightrope the boundary and got into Texas territory near the 47-yard line. So, Rice, a nice return, but...
Well, good job taking around the edge here. Just kind of running. Beasley doesn't make the initial contact there in the tackle, so good blocking there by the Owls, and kicker has to come over and try to knock him out of bounds.
40-yard return on the play by Tyler Smith. And, well, I said the last possession, Gary, let's see what Rice chooses to do. There's 57 seconds left now. A much better field position, obviously, and you have three timeouts to work with, or do you just take it to the house and talk about it?
You're definitely going to try to put points on the board. You've got great field position here, but you're going against a defense that Texas has been pretty stingy tonight. They've played very, very well, very sound defensively, and we've got a good defensive game plan and good system. A lot of pressure on the quarterback here.
Clement throws this one away.
Defense coordinator Dwayne Akin, who's on the sideline there, calls the pressure there, but he's going to get a penalty here because one of his guys hit the quarterback late on the play.
Yeah, seeing pointing his head saying, hey, come on now, got to use your head. We got a 41-point lead.
Got a feisty Hawaiian there. He's getting a little upset. And, yeah, what a great man and a great coach that he is here for this program and what he's done over his career and now getting a chance to be the defensive coordinator. He's been very unselfish over the years.
Yeah.
Of guys being stepped up. He's been stepped over essentially with other coordinators coming here. Gene Chizik a year ago. But he's getting a chance to be that guy.
Personal
right now.
Foul, roughing the quarterback. Defense, helmet to the head. 15-yard penalty, first down.
And more about Akina. You know, he's primarily the defensive backs coach and works with the secondary. And has he put together some talent? He has put some guys. Just look at the numbers here. All these guys in the NFL. And it's just tremendous what he's been able to accomplish with his skills and how he coaches and what he teaches. And he's a guy that knows how to get it done and usually has great players in the secondary.
First and 10 for Rice after the penalty, and this one is complete as Palmer runs the receiver Henderson. He is headed for the sideline, out of bounds, stops the clock, 46 seconds remaining. Again, Rice still has those three timeouts, and you know, Rice, they're not looking at the scoreboard now. Dave Bailiff's going, like you're saying, I got great field position. We need to be working our offense regardless of the situation and see what we can come up with. We may not get this good an opportunity the rest of the night. We don't know.
Yeah, do something here in this positive field position. Make positive plays, and utilize the clock and time management.
Second and 7. Texas coming after him, and it is complete. This time to number 6, Randolph, and Randolph spins. Stopped at the 20-yard line. Palmer covering again. Ryan, a sophomore from Arlington, Texas, out of Bowie High School.
Gain of 9 on the play.
Good efficiency here. Just throw the ball outside, get out of bounds. Just keep moving down the field. Patrick Randolph has had several balls thrown his way tonight.
So it'll be first and 10 at the 18-yard line with 28 and counting now, seconds remaining. Clement going for the end zone, and Dixon got him, and Rice is on the board with a TD. Torin Dixon, a sophomore from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, beats Beasley in the end zone, and the Owls have their first TD.
Now, there'll be no shutout here as Beasley just kind of gives a little bit of room inside. He moves in there and turns around, and that's what does him in. You can't turn your back to the receiver. You've got to be able to stay with him, and he needs to work more with him to the sideline. Good job of throwing the football out there and make it allowing your receiver to catch it.
So James Casey will hold as Clark Fangmeyer will go for the PAT. And he hits it. So he is 8 of 8 on the season. 3 plays, 40.
All right. Let's see. Texas has scored on a 13-second drive, a 1-play, 7-second drive. They're still dangerous on the kick return, and it goes out of bounds, the flag throw.
They get the ball up the 35-yard line, and I'd be surprised if Texas just doesn't take a knee here on this play to get into the get in at halftime and end this quarter. So I'm going to ask Colt McCoy to go out there and end this thing for the half anyway.
Stay with us. The Hitachi Halftime Show coming up. Mike Leeds and DeMarco Farr will handle it for you. Lots of highlights and scores to look at. We're talking about...
35-yard line. First down.
How about Nebraska today? What a scare from Ball State in Lincoln.
That was an interesting ball game, to say the least. A lot of scoring going on there for those two teams, and a lot of points being put up in the Big 12 teams today.
First and 10, and take the snap. McCoy hand it off to Charles, and that ought to end the first half here. As Texas, complete control. Ozugwu made the tackle on the play, and the Longhorns will head to the locker room with a 41-7 lead over the Rice Owls. And we'll send it down to Emily Jones with Mac Brown.
Coach, we talked about feeding the monster. Not quite perfect. Your defense gives up the touchdown on that last drive, but you got to be pleased with the way your team's playing overall.
Well, Emily, we are. We thought we played really well the first half, but we're not playing complete halves. The kickoff where they get the return and then score right before the half, the last 5 minutes, is so critical. So we've got to come back out with an attitude that we're starting over, and we don't give up long kickoff returns and don't give them easy points there at the end of the half.
A couple of your guys get banged up. How much time will your starters see in the second half, Colt included?
Well, it depends on how the game's going. We're trying to send a message here to us. This is about us getting better and us finishing drives and us finishing halves. And I'm really disappointed we didn't finish that half like we should have.
All right, Coach, best of luck in the second half. We do appreciate it. Once again, the Texas Longhorns lead this one 41-7. We now send it to the studios in L.A. where Mike...
Those are